हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट दी आर्डिनो एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट रास्पबेरी पाई. सो व्हाट इज़ अ रास्पबेरी पाई? अ रास्पबेरी पाई इज़ अ क्रेडिट कार्ड साइज कंप्यूटर ओरिजिनली डिजाइंड फॉर एजुकेशन इंस्पायर्ड बाई दी 1981 बीबीसी माइक्रो. ओके, सो बेसिकली रास्पबेरी पाई इज़ अ स्मॉल साइज और वी कैन से द क्रेडिट कार्ड साइज कंप्यूटर. ओके, एंड ओरिजिनली डिजाइंड फॉर एजुकेशन. ओके, सो दिस इज़ अ स्मॉल टाइप ऑफ कंप्यूटर. यू यूज़ द कंप्यूटर एंड लैपटॉप एंड यू डू मैनी थिंग्स इन द कंप्यूटर. सो ऑल द थिंग्स कैन ऑल्सो बी डू ऑन द रास्पबेरी पाई. ओके, सो क्रिएटर इबन Opton's goal was to create a low-cost device that would improve programming skills and hardware understanding at the pre-university level. Okay, so the Raspberry Pi is slower than the modern laptop or a desktop, but is still a complete Linux computer and can provide all the expected abilities that implies at a low power consumption level. So we can do all the things, like we can install Linux on it and we can install Windows 7 also on it, because Microsoft also released some Windows version specially for the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so we can install it and we can connect our Raspberry Pi with the display, or we can say we can also connect our Raspberry Pi with the projector. Okay, so we have all type of capability with the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so what is the Raspberry? So some basic things about the Raspberry Pi is that we have a three version of Raspberry Pi. First is a Raspberry Pi 1, so the original Raspberry Pi, and it has a 256 MB of RAM, and which increased to 2 MB in later version. So in the original version it has a 256 MB RAM, then they increase the RAM to 51 MB RAM. Okay, so it has a 26 way GPIO connector. So same like the Arduino, Raspberry Pi also have a general purpose input output pins, GPIO. Okay, so then we build the Pi Zero, and Pi Zero includes the GPIO connector, but the header pins are not soldered. Okay, so because Pi Zero is very small size, and it has all the functions of type of Raspberry Pi, but some ports are not there, like Ethernet port are not come with the Raspberry Pi Zero. Then many such type of things which is not necessary for the Raspberry Pi is removed and built on small version. So if anyone requires such quality in a Raspberry Pi, then they can opt for the Raspberry Pi Zero also. Okay, then programmer developed the Raspberry Pi 2. The Raspberry Pi 2 is fabbed the single core processor for a much faster quad core processor and increase the memory to 1 GB. Okay, so now our RAM is increased, and our RAM become 1 GB RAM, and now we have a single core processor and also we have a quad core processor. Okay, so now processing power is increased. Then we have a Raspberry Pi 3, and Pi 3 changes the processor to even more powerful 64-bit processor, just like the our computers. Okay, and it also adds the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, which is previously needed to added as a USB device. Okay, so previous version we have to add using the USB device, but now all the facility like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth are added, so we don't worry about it. The Raspberry Pi 3 model B was launched in February 26. So up to now we have a Raspberry Pi 3. Okay, so Raspberry Pi is capable of doing all the things which can do the our normal PC or laptop. So to get the Raspberry Pi working, an SD card needs to be prepared with the Linux operating system installed. So whatever we want to run in the micro in the Raspberry Pi. We will load it on the SD card because there is no any storage device in the Raspberry Pi. We have to insert the storage device by using the SD card, or we can insert by using the USB port, because there are 4 USB port are there with the Raspberry Pi. So we can connect the our our storage data bank. Okay, so we can add the hard drive, USB hard drive with the Raspberry Pi. Also, we can connect the our pen drive to the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so Raspberry Pi users have made many creative and impressive projects using this device, and it can also be programmed to assist in housekeeping your network by functioning NAS, IDAP server, web server, media server, DNS server. So we can do many things with the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so Raspberry Pi Foundation recommends the Python. So any language which will compile for ARM v6 can be used. So installed by default on the Raspberry Pi, C, C++, Java, Scratch, Ruby. So we can use many language, but especially Foundation recommends the Python. Okay, so now we will see about the board. What is the contents of board? So figure shows the Raspberry Pi board. The Raspberry Pi does not have any separate CPU, RAM or GPU. Instead, they all are squeezed into one component called a system on chip or SoC unit. So all the things, CPU, ARM, GPU, all are put in the same board. So Raspberry Pi is open hardware with the expectation of its primary chip and the board Chrome SoC, which runs the main component of board, CPU, graphics, memory, USB controllers, all are there. Okay, so this is a Raspberry Pi board. Okay, so this figure is not clear enough, but we can see all the components. Okay, so start with the USB. So this is USB 2.0, and this is I think this is a Raspberry Pi 2. Okay, so in Raspberry Pi 3 we have a 4 USB port. Okay, so here we have only 2 port, USB 2.0 2 port. One is upper and another one is in the lower portion. Then we have a Ethernet out, so only 256 MB models. So we can connect directly Ethernet cable to the Raspberry Pi for Ethernet. Then we have a CSI connector camera, so we can also connect the camera. So this is very important thing, that whenever we want to connect the camera, and camera needs the computer type of system, then we can use this Raspberry Pi at that place. Okay, then we have a HDMI out for a display device. So if we want to display, because Raspberry Pi is the CPU only. Okay, so we need to connect it with the monitor. So by using HDMI cable we can connect it to the monitor. Okay, then this is a Broadcom chip, BCM 2835 ARM 11700 megahertz. Okay, so this is the processor or heart of the Raspberry Pi. Then we have a micro USB power, so type C charger is used to power this Raspberry Pi board. Then we have a SD card slot back to the board, so we can load the system or any operating system on the SD card, then insert it into the Raspberry Pi. Okay, then we have a DCI display connector, so also we have a DCI type of display connector. So if we don't want to connect the with the HDMI, then we can also connect it, because some small displays are there. If you directly want to a small display, then a small display is come with the DCI connector. Okay, so we can directly connect it with the Raspberry Pi. Okay, then we have a GPIO headers for using the or we can say that for connecting the some input output devices. then we have a RCA video out, so we have a also have a RCA video output. Then we have a GTJ headers. Then we have a audio out also. So if we do anything that needs audio, or we can say that we can also watch a movie on it. Okay, so if we install any software that can display the movie, then we can simply open the player and insert the pen drive, and we can watch the video. We can watch all the YouTube video or anything video, because if we install the Linux or any operating system on it, then we can install the Chrome browser and all the things. So if we want to watch a YouTube video on it, then we can also watch it. Okay, then we have a status LEDs are there. Okay, so this is the board. You can see this is the another view of that board. So this is how our Raspberry Pis look like. Okay, so all of these Raspberry Pi models share the following features. First is operating system is Raspbian, BMC, Arc, Linux, or Rise OS, or Open Alexi, Petrora. So we can install any of this system. We can especially we Raspberry Pi is come with the Raspbian. Okay, so we install the Raspbian. We can also install the Linux. Okay, so then we have a video out HDMI signal. Then supported resolution are 640x350 to 920x1200. Okay, so including 1080p. okay, so it is a very good thing that we have a such a good resolution with the such a credit card size device. Okay, then this is very most important thing, that we can power by using the micro USB port. Okay, so this is the thing that if we power this device by using a charger, then it means that it only consume some milliampere, or we can maximum up to 1 ampere. Okay, so this is very good thing that the such a small device and such a low power consumption. Okay, so Raspberry Pi is a very unique thing, and definitely if you have a chance, then use this Raspberry Pi for some of your work, then it will create a very good impact. Okay, so this is it for today. In next lecture, we will see the many things, processor, memory, USB ports and all. Okay, so up to now, if you have any kind of doubt, then you can definitely comment it down.